Bismillahirrahmanirrahim and Assalamu alaikum. Wishing you all a very good morning. I hope all of you are fine and healthy at your home. I'm also good, Alhamdulillah. So students, what we are going to learn today? As you know, we have started our chapter number 11, Fundamental Concepts of Geometry. So this is the topic that we are going to discuss today, okay? So overall, this is your lecture number 27, and obviously the topic belongs from your geometry section, and I am your math teacher, Ms. Falaknaz. So let's quickly revise what we have learned so far. What we have learned so far? In the previous lecture, we have done some questions from exercise number 11.3, and then we also learned the definitions of angles and its kinds. Okay, so what we are going to learn today, what are today's lecture content? Today we are going to learn how to measure the angles, then definition of perpendicular and adjacent angles, and the last one is vertical angle. So these are the three topics that we are going to discuss today. So let's start from topic number one, measurement of angles. So measurement of angles, how will you measure the angle? We measure the angles with a protractor. Now what is a protractor? As you can see, this is your protractor, okay? D-shaped protractor, okay? Now, what you have in that? There are two rows, inner and outer of degrees, marked from 0 to 180 on the curved edge of the protractor. Now look at here, what you have, 1 minute. Now look at here, what you have, just suppose as you can see that this is the inner row, okay? And this is the outer row, or you can say this is the outer scale and this is the inner scale, okay? So if you look here in the inner scale, the degrees start from 0, then 10, then 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and then it will end it and here, that is 180 degree. Okay, means it is starting from right and end towards the left. And you can see here that your upper scale, or you can say the outer row, start from 0 from the left side, then 10, 20, 30, 40, and then at the end 180. Okay, so basically these are two scales, the upper scale or the outer scale or inner scale. Okay, so we are going to use this scale for measuring the angles. A small mark is given in the middle of the straight edge called the center of the protractor. Now, as you can see here, this is the straight edge, and you can see this is the small point here. Okay, this is small point, basically it is called as the center of the protractor. Okay, now move on to the next one. So we are going to start exercise number 11.4, and in 11.4 you have a question. Construct angles of the following measures with the help of protractor and name them accordingly. Means you have to write down the name of these angles as well as you have to construct these angles. Okay, construct means you have to draw the angles of the given measurement. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to draw the angles. So please tell me if my video is clear or not. Is it clear? I hope it is clear. Okay, now let's start from exercise number 11.4. As you all know that you should write down the date first. Okay, this is must. You have to write down your date first, then exercise number on the red line. After that, you will write your question. What is your question here? Construct angles of the following measures with the help of protractor and name them accordingly. Means here is the measurement, that is measurement angle PQR, that is equals to 67 degree. So what you have to do, you have to construct the angle of 67 degree. Okay, now as you can see here, P, Q and R. So basically this Q is your vertex. Okay, this is your vertex upon which your angle will be made. What is a vertex? The joining point of two line segments. When the line segment join with each other, so this is called as the vertex. Okay, so I'm going to draw the angle. So to draw the angle, what you will require? Okay, to draw the angle, what you will require, you will require this kind of protractor. As you can see, this is a protractor, okay, that is used to measure or that is used to draw the angle. So we are going to draw the angle with the help of this protractor. Or as you can see here, what you have, the two scales here. Number one, this is the outer scale and this is the inner scale. Okay, inner scale is start from zero here and outer scale will start from here. Okay, now for this, what you will do, as you know that the angle consists of two non-collinear rays. So first I'm going to draw the first ray. Okay, first I'm going to draw the ray number one like this. Any line, any ray, okay, of any measurement, ray of any measurement means it is not necessary that you required a specific measurement of the ray. You will draw a line. Okay, this is the point, or you can say the end point. And this is the point that is extended indefinitely only in one direction. That's why we will call that this is the ray. Okay, now we are going to draw the angle of 67 degree. So what we will do, as you know that this is the center point. Okay, what is it? This is the center point of the circle. So I am going to place this center point on this one, mean this line. Okay, this line of the, I'm talking about this line. Okay, this line of the protractor should be coincide with this line. Okay, just like this. Okay, this is my ray. Okay, and my line of the protector is joining, coinciding with the line of the ray. Okay, now this is your center point. Now what we are going to do, you are going to construct the angle of 67 degrees. So for this, you will start from the lower scale. Okay, you are going to start from the lower scale from this side, 0, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and 70. So you are going to draw the angle of 67 degree. So 67 will be lie in between 60 and 70. Okay, so this is 60 and this is 65. Okay, 65, 66, and 67. So 67 lies here. So we will make a dot here. And then we are going to join this dot with our first ray like this. Okay, and then we are going to make an arrowhead here because it is a ray. Now the measurement of this angle is basically 67 degree. Okay, the measurement of this angle is 67 degree. And now we are going to label it PQR. So Q is your vertex. Okay, Q is your vertex. This is P and this is R. Okay, now the angle of 67 degree will be an acute angle. Okay, we have to name them accordingly. Okay, and also we will write the answer here. So this is an acute angle. Okay, now after that we are moving towards our next question, that is question number 2. And here you have measurement angle ABC. Measurement angle ABC, you have to construct the angle ABC that is equals to 90 degree. Okay, 90 degree angle you are going to draw here. So let's check it out. How will you draw the angle? Okay, first you will draw a small ray. Okay, you will draw a ray here, first ray of any measurement. Then you will place your protector over this line segment just like this, and then mark 90 here. Where is 90 lie? This is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. So 90 lies here. So we will place a small dot here, and then we are going to join this line with our previous line like this. Okay, so we are going to place an arrowhead here. So what it will become? It will become the angle of what? Angle of 90 degree. Okay, now we are going to label it ABC. So what will be ABC here? This is your A, this is your B, that is vertex, and the last one is the point C. Now which angle is this? Angle of 90 degree is called as right angle. Okay, we are going to write down the answer here as well. So we are going to write it down here that it is a right angle. Okay, this is a right angle. Understand? Now move on to the next one. As you can see here, whenever I'm going to start from a new page, I always write down the what? Write down the date and as well as the exercise number that we are going to do. Question number 3, measurement angle x, y, z that is equals to 180 degree. Okay, x, y, z, this is your vertex, that is y, and on vertex y you will draw the angle 180 degree. So let's start. Again, draw a small ray, okay, of any measurement, just like this. Then place the arrowhead here. Then place your D over this line. Make sure your D line and your ray line should be coincide with each other. Now start reading. We are going to read the lower scale. Okay, we are going to read the lower scale because we are starting from the right side. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Then 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, and 180. So 180 lies here. That's why we are going to place the dot here. Okay. Now we are going to join this line. How? Look at here. Like this. So as you can see here, a straight line will be formed. That's why we will call that it is a straight angle. Now this is your vertex, okay, and on this vertex you are going to make you have make the angle of 180 degree, and then this is x, this is y, and this is z. Okay, now the angle of 180 degree is called as straight angle. This is a straight angle. So I'm going to write down the answer here as well. So what will be the answer? This is a straight angle. Clear? Okay. Now let's check number 4. Number 4, in number 4, what do you have? Measurement angle E. Okay, only one point is given. Angle E. So what does it mean? This angle E is your vertex. Okay. And you are going to draw it the angle of 250 degrees. So how will you draw it? If you look here, the measurement starts from 0 and ends at 180 degree. Okay, start from 0 and ends at 180 degree. So there is no 250 degree on this scale. Okay, so what you will do, obviously, you will subtract it from 360 degree. First, you will subtract it from 360 degree, 360 minus 250 degree. So what it will be? 110 degree. It means you are going to draw the angle of 110 degree. Now let's check it out here. First, you will draw a small ray here. Small ray. Then this arrowhead. And then we are going to paste it with each other. Now let's start reading. 1 minute. We are going to read the lower scale. 0. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. 90 after 90, 100 and 110 on the lower scale. And 110 on the lower scale. So 110 is here. Now, join this point with the line given. And then place the small arrow here. Then it means, what is it? This is the angle of 110 degree, but 110 degree angle is not required. Your required angle is 250 degree. Your required angle is 250 degree. So where is 250 degree angle? This is the angle of 100 degree. Okay. So basically this side will be of what? This side will be of 250 degree. 250 degree. And this is your vertex, that is called E. Okay. So 250 degree angle is basically a reflex angle. So the answer is, your answer is reflex angle. Clear? Is it clear? Please tell me, is it clear? Now look at here. What you are going to do, first you will write down your question here. Then write down the name of the angle, given angle. Then construct this angle just like this way with the pencil. Write down the name as well here. And then write down their, and also label it P, Q, R, A, B, C. This is must. Just like here, X, Y, Z. And the last one is E. Okay. So I hope it is clear to all of you. So let's move back to the slides again. Give me 1 minute.
Okay, so students, what we have done so far? We have done this exercise number 11.4 and I have shown you how to draw this type of angles. Now let's move on to the next one. Now our next topic is perpendicular. So what is the definition of perpendicular? When two lines, how many lines are there? Two lines and line segment. Okay, now what is lines and line segment? This is a line, okay, that has no end point. Means it is extended indefinitely in both direction, and this is a line segment that has two end point. So if you have any two lines and line segment, and when they intersect means they, when they will cut each other, when they will divide each other, so at a right angle, okay, at a right angle we say that they are perpendicular to each other. Means just suppose this is a line, okay, and now this another line number 2 is intersecting your line number 1 in such a way that after it they will form the angle of 90 degree. So what does it mean? It means these lines are perpendicular to each other. Okay, this mean that these lines are perpendicular to each other. As you can see here, symbolically it is denoted by this symbol. This is a symbol of perpendicular. Perpendicular means a line that is perpendicular to each other. So this is a symbol of perpendicular. Now let's check it out, this one. What is this? In the adjoining figure CD. Okay, now what is the CD? This line segment. This is CD. Okay, CD is perpendicular to AB on this one. Okay, CD is perpendicular to AB. So what does it mean? Why CD is perpendicular to AB? Because after intersecting, they are making the angle of 90 degree. So that's why we will say that CD is perpendicular to AB. Also, we can say that this AB, okay, also what we can say that this AB is perpendicular to this CD. Why we are saying that? Because after intersecting, they are making the angle of 90 degree. That's why we will say these lines are perpendicular to each other. Now these are lines because they have arrows on both sides. Now if we talk about the line segment, so as you can see here, this is measurement MN. Okay, where is MN? This one. This is your MN, perpendicular to LM. It is perpendicular to LM. Why it is perpendicular to LM? Because after that, after intersecting, they are making the angle of 90 degree. Or also you can say that this LM is perpendicular to MN. Okay, so this is a symbol of perpendicular. In other words, two perpendicular lines intersect each other at an angle of 90 degree. Means what you can say that? You can say that two perpendicular lines can also intersect each other at an angle of 90 degree. Next topic is adjacent angles. Adjacent means side by side, barabar mein. Okay, so two angles. Here we are talking about two angles having the same vertex. Vertex means the point where two lines join with each other. Okay, so two angles having the same vertex and one common arm. Okay, two angles having the same vertex and one common arm, they are called adjacent angle. Now consider this one. This one, okay, this is your angle 1. Like how it is angle 1? Angle BOC. Okay, so this is your angle number 1, okay, and this is your angle number 2. These angles are not adjacent to each other because they do not have a common vertex. The vertex of this is here and the vertex of this angle is this one. Okay, so obviously the vertex is not common, as well as they do not have any common arm. So we will say angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent. But as you can see in this figure, as you see in this figure, this is your angle number 1 and this is your angle number 2. And they both have the common vertex as well as the one common arm, this one, AB. Okay, so what we will say that angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent to each other. Okay, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent to each other. So measurement angle AOB, where is AOB? This AOB, and measurement angle BOC are adjacent angles. Okay, so these type of angles are adjacent angles. Now look at here, there are three arms, the first arm, second arm and third arm. The outer, these are outer arms and this one is the inner arm, that is the common arm. So adjacent angles are those that have same vertex and one common arm. Okay, now the last one is the vertical angle. Vertical angles, what are vertical angles? Two angles, again what you have, two angles whose arms are two pairs of opposite rays. Now here you need to understand what does it mean by pair of opposite rays. You know what are rays? That has one end point and it is extended indefinitely in one direction. So this is a ray, right? Now let's check it out. This is your ray 1, A, sorry, OA. Okay, this is your ray 1, OA. Then ray number 2, OB. Okay, now these are the one pair of opposite ray. Okay. Now let's consider this one. This is OC and this is OD. So as you know that these are the two different pairs of opposite rays. So what they will form? They will form angles. What angle? This angle and this angle. This is your angle 1 and this is your angle 3. So vertical angles are basically equal in nature. Okay, so any two angles whose arms are two pairs of opposite rays, these are called vertical angles. So angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical angles. Okay, and they are equal in measure. Just like that is measurement of angle 1 is equal to measurement of angle 3. Okay, after this, as you can see here, this is another angle that is making and this one. That is angle number 2 and angle number 4. So angle number 2 and angle number 4 are perpendicular to or vertical angles. Why vertical angle? Because they are the their arms are two pairs of opposite rays. So these are vertical angles. Okay. So in other words, pair of vertical angles are congruent. Now what does it mean? Pair of vertical angles are congruent. Congruent means equal. Okay, congruent means equal. Now what does it mean? Pair of vertical angle. Now what is a pair of vertical angle? 1 and 3. Okay, this is the one pair of vertical angle. If angle 1 is equals to 60 degree, so your angle 3 will also of 60 degree. Okay, because pair of vertical angles are equal. If your angle 2 is of 75 degree, so angle 4 will be of 75 degree as well. So vertical angles are equal in nature. So these are basically vertical angles. Okay, so that's the end of the lecture. This is the end of the lecture. Now we are moving back to the question answer session. Fill in the blank. So these are the questions that I'm going to ask with all of you. So two perpendicular lines intersect each other at an angle of dash. Please tell me the answer of this one. Okay, that's good. Two perpendicular lines intersect each other at an angle of, yes, 90 degree, or you can say right angle. Next one is two angles having the same vertex and one common arm are called dash angles. Please tell me the answer of this one. Two angles having the same vertex and one common arm are called dash angles. Yes, very good. The answer is adjacent angles. Okay, now next one. Pair of vertical angles are dash. Pair of vertical angles are, yes, very good, Bete, congruent. Okay, pair of vertical angles are congruent, or you can say equal. Okay, the next is an angle of 360 degree is called dash. Now all of you please. Okay, now very good. Right. Yes, right. So an angle of 360 degree is called complete angle. Right, you are right. Now the last one, an angle of 90 degree is called, wow, very good. Right, the correct answer is called right angle. An angle of 90 degree is called right angle. Now that's the end of the lecture. Now please open your books, all of you. Open your books, chapter number 11, page number 158, 159 and 160. What you have to do here, you have to mark the important points. Now open your book on page number 158. You have the definition of perpendicular. So kindly underline these lines in your book, page number 158. Then this definition is also continue on the next page, that is page number 159. Yes, and then on page number 159, you have the definition of adjacent angle as well. This adjacent angle, so kindly highlight this one. And this is the adjacent angles. Done. Okay, students, please give me 1 minute. I am going to take your attendance as well. So please do not go anywhere. Students, please tell me, have you done? Okay, that's good. Now, last one, vertical angles. Page number 160, and this is the definition of vertical angle. Two angles whose arms are two pairs of opposite rays, they are called vertical angles. Then, this is a figure of vertical angles. Done. Okay, students, please tell me when you done. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, now class, if you want to ask anything, if you have any question, please ask. No, beta, there is no quiz today. Okay, there is no quiz today. I'm not going to take any quiz. No, please do not get confused. Okay, yes, I will upload the homework today. Yes, students, I am going to upload the homework today as well. Anything else? Okay, please tell me, is it clear? Okay. So, you are not going to ask any more question. So, sorry. Meera, what's wrong with you, bete? Why you are continuously typing so many wrong things? Yes, I am going to post the assignment today. I am going to give you the homework today. And in the homework, you have definitions along with the figures. So kindly draw the figures in where? Draw the figures on interleaf page with pencil. Okay? Yes, okay. Okay, so students, you are not interested in asking any more questions. So at the end, I would like to say thank you. Thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much for listening to me. I will always thankful to you. And I hope you enjoyed today's lecture. We will meet you in the next lecture, inshallah. Till then, Allah Hafiz.